long way, about a few months, almost a year since we met, Lipti.
Yeah.
Okay. So we did one, we started one event here called the Elegant Eating for Children. What I do is I'm an image consultant by profession. People say that this is a very intriguing profession. Image consulting andre yen maartira antane kelavaru normally. Okay, image consulting andre image andre yeno yena artha antarthe nimge. What do you think image is? Personality. Somebody said personality here. One's own personality. How do you look at yourself? Okay.
How people look at you.
Yes. Image. What is image? Image means whatever you're projecting about yourself is your image. Right? Whatever you are from within is your self-image. What do you think of yourself is your self-image. Now, image also means external. That means your clothing, grooming, the way you speak, your communication skills, the way you stand, etc. So, image is an overall picture of what you are from within and what you show to people or what people can see about you, right? So, I'm a certified image consultant. So, I do one-to-one consulting for individuals. I also do corporate training programs in different corporate organizations. I also do group programs to people who are not part of corporate organizations, but they do not want to do one-to-one consulting. People like you, I have a program called The Elegant Woman. The Elegant Woman is a two-day program. There are many other programs also that come under The Elegant Woman. The two-day program which is more popular is basically the one-day program for clothing. Now, there are different body shapes. Once we have children and married, children age, the body loses its original, beautiful shape that we have, and we get into different body shapes. Somebody has probably a triangular body shape, somebody has an inverted triangle, somebody has a tubular body shape, somebody has a voluptuous hourglass body shape. All these body shapes are certain variations that we have from time to time, right? Now, clothing, how you dress yourself should depend upon your body shape, okay? So suppose somebody is triangular, the shoulders are narrow, and as we go down, the hips become large, okay? So a person with triangular body shape should not wear a certain kind of clothes, should not wear a certain kind of lines on the clothes, should not wear certain colors at the bottom, should not wear certain prints at the bottom, should do a few things up over here close to the neck so that the attention goes up. This is very important. These are technical details which people don't understand. Normally, what do? We go down to maybe a mall, any mall around here, good mall around here in Bangalore, and we see somebody wearing a certain kind of clothing, and then we say, oh, this is so good. I think I would like to buy something like this. And we go hunting, everywhere. Do you have this? Which brand is this? And we try and follow that person to to some distance to find out which is the brand. And then we go into that shop and we buy the same thing. We see some color, some print on somebody, and we say, I want that color which that lady was wearing, and that print which that lady is wearing, and then that type of dress, the style of the dress which that lady is wearing. I want to combine all this and make a visual composite of all these things and put it on myself. Well, that may not be my personal style. Now, what we are as people from within, we have a lot of strengths, especially women, we have a lot of strength. Our clothes should speak for us. What we are from within should be what people understand about us, right? So if you have, if you're a person who is probably bold, who would like to be seen as a person who's an outspoken person, then you should wear clothes which depict that. You should wear accessories which would depict that. If you're a person who is a little shy by nature, if you are a person who does not know how to mingle, this happens, cannot make friends very quickly, then you may want to compensate for that with your clothes. If you are a person who is very tall and broad-built, Okay? You may want to wear clothes that make you look a little more softer. The concept of yin and yang. Yin and yang are Chinese concepts. Okay? These concepts exist everywhere in this world. And these concepts exist in us too. So if you are a person who is really voluptuous, or the body is a little, because of childbirth and things become a little loose, or you're a little wide in the body, then you should wear vertical lines. So if you're carrying a dupatta, if you want to look good and powerful, you might as well carry the dupatta on one side and not on two sides. If you want to look girlish, if you want to look cute and pretty, then maybe on two sides. But if you're going out in the evening for a very formal occasion, you should have something very formal on your neck. A good neck piece. Okay? But if you're going out in the day, maybe for a kitty party or something like that, you may want to carry nice floral bags or nice wedges for your heels, etc. I can see a lot of ladies smiling. Am I speaking your language?
Yes.
I guess so. Okay, now a little bit about self-image. Okay, since today we're celebrating the International Women's Day, it's important for me also to talk a little about how you can motivate yourself and keep yourself motivated from within. Okay, self-image should be very strong for any human being. Okay, now, I'm sure some of you must have been working somewhere, you've quit your jobs because you have had children, you want to look after your family. Some ladies here who are not part of any business, or you want to probably start something but you don't know where to begin. Or some of you who feel that, some of my friends, go and work outside. I feel that, I wish I had also done something different. If that little bit of hollowness is there in you, if there's a void in you, let me tell you where you may want to start. How many of you sitting here have something that you always wanted to do but you did not know how to go about this? Maybe you thought, I want to do it but I don't know how I look for doing it. I don't know what people will think. Okay, let me see after some time I do this. It could be anything. It could be joining a cooking class. It could be yoga. It could be aerobics. It could be music. I don't know. I don't think my voice, I can sing, but I want to learn singing. I wish I could dance. I saw many of you come here, you were dancing so beautifully. A class may help you to, feel good about yourself. How many of you can see some hands? You always wanted to do something, but something stopped you. Something inside here stopped you. It could be anything. It could be driving a bullet. Riding a bullet. You want to ride a bullet. How many of you have it? Aisa, vandu naan maadbekum taittu manasalli yavaglu ide, but naan shuru maadakke aagta illa. Yenadru irbodu. Naan dance kalibeku, music kalibeku, cooking kalibeku, baking is one thing. Baking kalibeku, gardening maadbeku. It could be anything. Skating. Why don't you do it now? Why don't you do it now? Who's stopping you? There's only one person who's stopping you, which is yourself. You are stopping yourself from doing what you want to do always. Nobody else. Okay, self-image is what do you feel about yourself? Mostly we get into this comparative mode, I'm always comparing myself to somebody else. What that person is doing, I also want to do. But that person is, slightly better than me. No, maybe I'm better than that person. Okay, that person is better than me in this. I think I'm better than that same person in this. So we are equal. So I don't need to do anything extra. As long as I'm equal, I'm okay. Okay, this is negative energy. Please stay away from this. Look at yourself, look inward. Do anything that you wanted to do always now. Start now. Now is the time. Enhance your self-image. Feel very good about you. You should be your best critic and you should be your best motivator. You don't need anybody else. Okay, I just want to request all of you. I do a lot of programs, like I said, about under the banner of the Elegant Woman. I have my own company, which is called the Image Styling Studio. We are on Facebook. So please, if you are on Facebook, please visit us there and be part of our page. Image Styling Studio, that is our page. Okay? I will be conducting a lot of programs for women, be it makeup, I will have another makeup artist here, makeup and grooming, or clothing. Smart shopping is another thing which is very popular. I don't know, when I go to shop, I go and pick up clothes and I come back and say that, you know, God, I don't like this. No, what do I wear this jacket with? I picked up this jacket, I don't know what should I wear it with. Most of the times I buy clothes, come back and they stay in the cupboard, I don't even use them. I wear them once and then I don't want them. So smart shopping is a module where you will understand how to prepare for shopping and how to shop where you don't waste your money and you use each of those clothes. Like that, I have a lot of modules. I will be putting together some modules very shortly under the banner of the Elegant Woman. If you are interested in understanding what the program is about and about the program, and if you may want to enroll, kindly leave your name and telephone number in the book which is there. Okay, so whenever we do a program for you, we will get in touch with you. Right? Now I think you're waiting for what is there on this paper. Let me not delay this any further. Okay, I have a list of categories and winners against them. Categories are the best name, best dressed group, best ramp walkers, best talent, sporting group, and jugaad group. Okay, so should we announce the prizes? Deepthi, please? Would you like to come here, Deepthi? Can we have Deepthi on stage? Would you like to announce?